Okay, well, we came today. I got a grant from Target to do a field trip with my students. And so I thought something that would be really neat for them is to have an experience of getting to see an interpreter. I teach sign language. And my students often only get to interact with the deaf with my co-teacher. And so it's usually through video. So I thought it would be really neat if they had the chance to see an interpreter at work and also learn some new signs. And a lot of times we just kind of teach conversational sign language. So with the aquarium, they're going to get exposed to watching the interpreter, and they're going to pick up marine and aquatic related signs, which will be something that'll be different than what we teach in our class. I'm excited about the opportunity to meet our students besides on Skype, and to give them the opportunity to practice with each other and just get comfortable with using sign language with me and with Mr. Gudafis, my co-teacher, and with each other. And so I'm excited about the experience you're going to have today.
I have a deaf and Down syndrome brother, and the family doesn't really get to go out and take classes, so this was my opportunity to teach family sign language.
I like getting to meet people because I am homeschooled, so it's usually me in a room by myself on a computer. And now there are people. I forgot they existed after a while. You think you're the last one there, and they actually exist.
The first thing we'll be doing is going out on a boat, and we're going to learn a little bit about marine life. And so they will get to test the water quality, look for animals and sea creatures.
There are pelicans. I think they look like little hawks. And that osprey, that may be one of ours from the nest.
Whale. Dolphin. Sea turtle.
Pirate ship coming.
Pirate ship is coming. For the pirate.
Pirate ship sinking.
Wow. That is the other osprey nest.
But
I was in the water with her. She still could not swim. So my job was to hold her up. So when I would get in the water with Winter, she was so tiny, she would actually lay on my belly. She would lay on top of my belly and she would put her head on my shoulder.
She came here when she was only a few months old and she's still growing, so just like you would need bigger shoes as you grow, Winter needs a bigger tail as she grows as well.
We're also gonna learn about the math and science behind how they created Winter's prosthetic tail. And so that's really neat because it's kind of cross content where you take math and science, but they're also learning sign language. And so I think it's important that we don't just teach these kids signs, hear sign language, but they're going to learn other subjects. And it's really important to kind of connect the dots.
Just as a scientist, especially here and at Hanger Clinic, you always got to try out and experiment your ideas to see if they'll work.
And it'll help them remember a lot of these signs too, because they're going to remember this experience. And then we'll also get to do a tour and see where they made the movie for A Dolphin Tale.